Hold HangChat in your hands. Download HangChat forklift app from App Store and Google Play.
Hello everyone, welcome back to HangChat TV. I'm Becky. I'll be the host for today's video and today we have a guest here. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Hello everyone, I'm Jay. I'm service engineer of HangChat.
And have you seen any of our recent HangChat videos?
Yes, of course.
And let me tell you about some advantages of our XC lithium battery forklift truck.
First is fast charging, and the second is high performance, and the third is long service lifetime.
Oh, so you actually know it pretty well. HangChat has a lot of lithium battery products, and more users start to pay attention to lithium battery maintenance, this topic. And I knew you're our service engineer. Could you tell us about maintenance of lithium battery from your point of view?
Okay, I think a lot of customers should know something about regular maintenance, but today I would like to tell you that problem is easy to ignore. After the charging is completed, we must cover the charging gun and the charging seat to protect the dust.
Is it dust cover really that important?
Yes, many people think they just plug in the charging gun and don't care if it's a dust cap is on after finish it. However, in our after sales consultant, there are many problems caused by the dust cap not covered or the charging gun doesn't insert completely.
Oh, but why is that?
First of all, the charging time of the lithium battery is less than 2 hours. Such a short time, the current will be much larger than the lead-acid battery. So, to ensure the safety, the charging logically set up safeguard procedures. Once it's found that it's the bad contact, for example, not inserted fully, it will report a fault code and it cannot into the charging process.
So how to connect completely?
When the gun is inserted, there is a switch on the gun head. If the switch not closed, the charger will report a fault code and cannot charging. The switch is check whether the gun and the charger port is fully in place. When no connection is in place, the switch is not closed.
So the charging gun has to be inserted completely and the switch must be closed. But what if the button gets accidentally pressed or it's released? What are we gonna do?
If the switch is disconnected during the charging, the charge will pause and it is necessary to plug out and then plug in again to restart the charging.
But what if something goes into the port or the gun?
If there is something or water in the charging port, it will cause a bad contact. Then failure or the charging in severe cases. Spark may be even appear. There will be electrical leakage if water goes inside.
Really? Is it really that matter if the dust goes in as well?
Dust and other things are the main cause of the poor contact. Let's start with a formula of Q equals I squared RT. This formula is called Joule's law, where Q is the heat value, I is output of the current charge, R is resistance, and T is the charging time. Bad contact will cause the charging resistance to increase. So the heat value or the charging port will increase. When it raises to a certain degree, a temperature sensor on the charging port will remind the charger, then protect itself from overheating and stop charging. Until the temperature drops down before the recharging. At the same time, there is a layer on the severe plate on the charging contact surface to increase the electrical conductivity. As we know that all the metals, the silver conducted electric best, followed by the copper and the gold. The dust particles in the charging mounts, like sandpaper, weird away the surface as they plug in and out so that the highly conductivity survey on the surface disappeared quickly. The water rough surface charged from the face to the point contact as the contact area decreases, the resistance increases during the charging.
Oh, I see what you mean. So I would like to ask for our audience, how can we avoid these kind of situations in our daily use?
It's pretty simple. Dust cap must be covered and after the charger. Regularly clean the charging connector in the daily use.
And that's all?
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Jay, for today's discussion. And that's pretty much about it. If you like our videos or find it helpful, please like our videos or subscribe us. And we will see you here next time. Bye.
If you like our videos, please click to subscribe and share. Search Hangcha Forklift on YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram to see more videos.